And a good Wednesday to you. I'm meteorologist Cindy Fitzgibbon. There is colder air sitting just to our west that is going to be working in gradually over the next 24 to 48 hours. You're going to feel a big change. This storm is going to sit to our north and strengthen, and that's going to crank up the winds and allow some of that colder air to work on in. But look at the snow flying. It's going to continue pretty much all day long across parts of central northern New England. The ski area is going to get some good snow out of this. Here locally, a few snow showers this morning in the Worcester Hills should dry up by lunchtime, but snow showers may persist on into the afternoon out here in the Berkshires, where we may see some additional accumulation on the order of another 1 to possibly up to about 3 inches in some spots. Lighter amounts as you head up into southern New Hampshire. We may have a few scattered coatings through the highest elevations of the Worcester Hills. In the Boston area, clouds breaking for some sunshine. We'll kind of be in and out of the clouds with limited sunshine on into the afternoon, but we're drying out. And notice how the temperatures are coming up through the 40s and holding fairly steady through the afternoon, but the winds are going to be busy, sustained around 20 miles per hour. So even though we're going to be running in the 40s, the wind is going to make it feel colder, and that wind may gust to 45 miles per hour. There is a wind advisory up through about 4 o'clock this afternoon. That may be strong enough to do some damage, so keep that in mind. The winds kind of gradually come down a little bit overnight, but they're still going to be out of the west 5 to 15. So it's going to feel colder than this. We'll be in the upper 20s and lower 30s, cold enough for some icy spots. So do watch for that overnight. Tomorrow is another dry day, more clouds than sunshine. Still windy and getting colder. Temperatures are going to be in the upper 20s and upper 30s tomorrow as our storm sits to the north and strengthens. The wind's not as strong tomorrow, but still some gusts over 20 miles per hour, just making it feel even colder. So you'll notice that wind chill on Thursday, but look at this on Friday, a high only in the 20s. In the morning, we're going to be in the teens, but the wind chill is going to be running below zero, and it only recovers on Friday afternoon into the single digits above zero. So cold end to the week, but it's dry. It's dry on Saturday as well. High temperatures still stuck in the 20s, and it looks like this big area of high pressure building out of Canada with the cold air is going to be enough to suppress a developing storm coming off the mid-Atlantic states to our south. There was some disagreement in our computer models earlier in the week, but now the bulk of them are keeping this storm to the south on Sunday. The northern edge of the snow may flirt with Nantucket, but that is about as far as it looks like it's going to get. So it does look dry for most of us here through the weekend. Could be a few coastal snow showers and flurries. Those would be ocean effect for that Patriots game, but cold air sticking with us through the weekend.